Good morning. Is it good afternoon? What's the time? Okay, I'm supposed to be here. Yeah, but on the greatest love, you also spoke to me of the elf and the antelope. But that queer mother. It seems that the Khoisan leadership here was at the field. Almost a Bura. Was at Bura. Okay. Yeah, that's all right. And what's that? No. That's what we did back to fight. He was kind of some observations. Just to think that the living president Mr. Kunovar recommended from several observations to back. Parosas by that one that he and the others for days some of them. And for us archived that in the Anna Samans we are going to give Mr. Kunovar an opportunity just to make a few reflections on his observations and he's one of the member of parliament to address the issue of cloud challenges in the Northern Cape with the deputy president. That's the reason why they are voting. And then thereafter, we'll give the deputy president an opportunity to make also reflection on his own observations. And then thereafter, we just open the floor for a flow of engagements between us and anyone on the farm. We've got the Minister of Agriculture, no, Minister of Land Reform. He's also here, he's Thoko, Didiza. She just went to refresh her hands, but she will be joining us. Can we agree on that process? Are you guys all comfortable with that? Okay, can we then give Mr. Kunovar just to make his reflection?
Let me start by saying the following, that I think that today, well, for the first time, I experienced what they say, government in practice. In Parliament, I've posed a question to the Honourable Deputy President on the drought, specifically in the Northern Cape, and he then decided to say, well, let's go and see what the circumstances are. And I think that is a good example of government in practice. So we talk in Parliament, and I think you can all now see and experience that it is not only talk. We had some discussions. The Honourable Deputy President will elaborate on the way forward from here. But I want, on behalf of myself and my party and the people, say thank you, Deputy President, for setting an example, not just to talk about the problems of South Africa, but physically come and see for themselves to see what the situation is. And I must say that I'm shocked to see the region. It looks like a desert. I'm not a farmer myself, but I grew up on a farm. Ek is 'n boer, as ek het so kan stel. En ek het geweldig gesympatie met ons mense wat in hierdie geharde omstandighede nog steeds aangaan. En ek sê altyd, dit is 'n onderskeidende eienskap, juist van die landbou en boere. Soos hulle sê, boer maak altyd 'n plan. Sterkte vir u, wees verseker dat ons van ons kant af en na die regering van hulle kant af binne hulle vermoëns, alles in die vermoë. Wat hulle kan doen, probeer hulle doen. There are some constraints, unfortunately. But I will, and I say, after all what I have experienced, and I saw some emotion when we have visited the farmer just now, just a word of some support is actually activating tears from the people. And that is actually an example of the very seriousness of the problem. Thank you very much. Thank you, Deputy President. En alles van die beste wil vir u. Ons sal opvolg hê, so as ek nie alles luister wat u sê nie, sal ek dit wel terug. Baie dankie.
Baie dankie, Groeneveld, en dan sal ons nog vir jou tot kus moet gaan doen.
Thank you very much, Premier, Minister, the Groeneveld, the MEC, and our farmers. Good afternoon. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Are you still alive?
Yes.
We are better. Are you okay? When we were coming here, we met some farmers along the way, and I said they must come and join us here. Is there anyone who can check where they are? Because I want them to be part of the meeting. Our main visit here is to visit farmers. So there can't be a meeting here of us with certain farmers outside certain farmers. So all of us, let's meet and discuss the topic. Well, the reason why we're here, it all emanated in Parliament. Mr. Groeneveld asked me a question about the Northern Cape farmers, and I tried to answer, and I realized, no, I'm begging to answer this question. And I then said, no. I suggest that probably we must go together and meet the farmers. Now, we took some time. All the political parties had something to say about the drought here. And from the question that was asked by Mr. Kruman, all other parties, so we spent some time talking about you. Not knowing you, but knowing that there are farmers with the problem. And that resulted in us coming here. I would say, Mr. Groeneveld, thank you for raising this matter. And then after that, I spoke to the Premier confirmed. He said, yes, no problem. In fact, I've been trying very hard all the time to declare this province a disaster stricken province. But I'm not succeeding. I'm happy that we are now raising the matter. Discuss the matter with the minister confirmed, yes, there's a problem. Oh, so Mr. Groeneveld was not lying, talking about the real problem. So we went around, I checked, I saw one farmer, I saw the area, I saw the drought. Your situation is terrible. So, and I don't know how you survive, you still wear ties here. How are you surviving here? Because it's difficult. You don't have water. If you don't have water, you can't farm. Not going to farm. Well, talking along the way, exchanging some ideas. But firstly, we spoke amongst ourselves as government. The province, to say what is the immediate response. Immediate, now that we're here and when we live here, there should be some immediate
give to farmers, that's not enough. Now, the first thing that we're going to do, we're going to add to what the province has done, we buy more fodder, give to the farmers. That is going to happen immediately. Today is Friday, next week, it will happen. It will be monitored by the Premier and the Minister. And I can come anytime to check. Check whether is there any relief. That's the first thing. Money is going to be reprioritized. They will tell me how much they can make available to purchase food on top of what the province has, so that there's an immediate relief. While we're in the house of one farmer, the farmer said, well, we've been in this situation for a long time, and we want something like a permanent solution. And the permanent solution is that probably if government can, if there's land in this province, in other regions of this province, where the drought is not severe like this one, can't government give us that land, lease that land to us, so that we can augment the situation here? And I immediately said, yes, possible. I said, we're not going to do it for you as a farmer, but we're going to do it for every farmer here. So that solution also covered yourself. That means if you go to Upington, if there's a farm there that is available, we can lease that farm for you. You farm there so that you can complement, you can keep some of your animals here, but you can grow further there, so that you can sustain yourself under this situation. And what else? What else can we do? Okay, let us not give up in terms of finding water. We're not going to give up. Where possible, we're going to drill and get water on the boats, so that at least there's a certain amount of water in your farm. So, in our collective approach to this problem in the Northern Cape, we're going to bring the Minister of Water Affairs, Water and Sanitation, Human Settlement, Water and Sanitation, to be part of this. Now, in the main, we're looking for underground water. And in the process, we're going to discuss with the mines here. Because some of the water that you're using currently now, you're getting it from the mines. And you own the mines. Want to see whether we can cancel that debt. Because probably one day you can commit suicide, I'm not sure. You see, we want to negotiate with the mines. See how best that we do away with the debt and see how best they contribute towards this problem. But in the process, we will bring the Department of Water and Sanitation. That's one approach. Is that all that we can do? We said no. And the farmer said, hey, in the process, we went, we made rooms in the land then, and we owe you. We owe you, and we are not surviving. Can you please speak to the land then about this debt? They can wait with this debt until our situation is fine.
We said, no, okay, we're going to take that problem. Dead from the mines, water, dead from land bank, these are things that we must discuss, because the farmers are not making any profit. Not making any profit. They need to be assisted until they break in from this problem. Said, okay, we are going to take that. These are some of the things that we are taking back home. The last thing we said, the province currently has got some farms and they are producing lucerne. And this is the lucerne that they are currently giving small bits and pieces to the farmers. And we said, part of the farms that belong to national government can also be given to the province to expand that operation. To expand that operation. But we don't want to create a dependency syndrome there, that you depend on us all the time. You see, clearly. We rather lease the farm to the farm, rather than give the farm to the provincial government, and the provincial government must take out money and farm and just hand out fodder. Why don't we agree on a long-term lease? Give that farm to the farm, and the farm farms, and the farm will learn to stand up. And the farmer must make a plan. As long as you've got the asset, the land. So that's another option that we are looking at. But I think the long and short of our story is that you have been in this problem for a long time. You've suffered. And we're here now. It was not going to last forever. Now that we managed to meet, the way we've met, we're now all of us confronted with the problem and we're not going to run out. We're going to be here until the problem is solved. We very lucky. When certain processes happened, the farmer that we visited, when he got his farm, when this minister was Minister of Land Affairs, and after complete cycle, they meet again. She's still minister now. That means they've got an issue to resolve. They're meeting again, they must resolve this issue. They must complete their journey. Their journey is incomplete. As farmers, you should be grateful. Especially here in the Northern Cape. You have got Minister Didiza. She understands how to work with farms. I'm not buying facts. She's got passion. Her heart is in the right place. And I'm sure she's going to make a difference in your life. You have got the premium. Very passionate about the problems. I've known him for a long, long time. Many, many years. Through thick and thin. So, these people that are here, you're fortunate. You, you have Kronenberg. Someone who grew up in a farm, he's not a farmer, but he knows the pain of a farm. When I'm staying in a farm, I farm a bit. You believe the story? That I'm my farm. Now, in my farm, I'm planting Mabuza trees. So I farm. I know how to go out there and farm. That is why I said, when I was asked this question, I said, no, I want to go see. Because it was easy for me to reply and stay in the city rather than come here and date my shoes. Because I am almost close to the life of a farmer. I know what a little farmer feels every day. When you wake up, I know how you feel. How you feel about your crop, how you feel about your animals. Your animals, your crops come first. So, more or less, we have a short-term solution. Before the end of the month, we will be knowing the amount of land portions that are available that you can lease to yourself so that you can farm. Complement the drought-stricken area, plant this side, feed this side. We'll come here and make an announcement to say, yeah, we've got 4 or 5 farms, we can give to so-and-so, 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 and the rest, this is what we're going to do. But we're now together in this program. We committed as a country that we must scale up our production. We are going to scale up our production. I'm sure you've seen the department has advertised for farms, for people who must come and lease, because we want to broaden. We want young people to come in, want women to come in, new entrances, so that we increase our production. That has happened. And in a short space of time, we'll be making fresh announcements in terms of redistribution of our land that we have, in terms of restitution of our land. The land that has been claimed will make those announcements. Now, we want to reiterate our point that we're going to work with everyone. We're going to work with everyone, we're going to support every farm, irregardless of your skin color. Every farmer who's here to produce for his or her own country, that farmer is going to be supported. Mr. Kronenberg is a leader of Freedom Front Plus. I'm a leader of the ANC. He raised the matter in Parliament. I did not look at the matter as a matter of the Freedom Front Plus. I looked at the matter as a matter that affects our country. That's why I'm here. I should have said, Grandpa, I'm not the member of Freedom Front. Go and solve that problem alone. But he said, no, there's a problem. So, the problems of this country don't require the ANC, don't require Freedom Front, don't require EFF, don't
don't require DA. The problems of this country require the people of South Africa. Before we become members of our own parties, we are members of South Africa. There are times and moments in our life where we must put the country first and its people. This is what we're doing here. We're not here to play politics because we understand your duty. Your duty is to provide food. This is a matter that we must take seriously. That's why we're here. Thank you very much. Now, what is going to happen? The minister working with the province and the premier, they will facilitate certain meetings. Where possible, where I must meet the mine management, where I must be part of the meeting with the land bank, I will do so. But finally, for the end of the month, we must come and report progress to say, you know, we have managed to achieve one, we have achieved this, we have achieved this, so we must still do this and this and this. Like I'm saying, we're now together in this chair. Thank you very much.